Have you ever wondered just how accurate photogrammetry is? Is it even close? Let's scan this stamped aluminum panel, and then we're going to recreate the data. We're going to compare it to its profile and see just how accurate it is for your everyday use, industrial design, and product development workflow.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber. My sponsor, PCBWay, is holding a design contest beginning in October where you can submit your project for consideration to be brought to life and sold on the PCBWay Bazaar. Check out the link below for your chance to have your ideas brought to life and earn some extra cash. This is a stock paint panel that one of my clients stamps out, and it comes this way with primer on the aluminum already. It's a little bit too shiny for our needs. I end up priming it with some gray primer and then speckling it with some black and white primer. You can see how I do that in one of my previous photogrammetry videos, and I'll link to that up here on the right. I also built this scanning rig in a previous video, and you can check out that link as well. And so I am capturing the information from this panel that we're going to pull into Metashape and use for our photogrammetry test. We're going to compare that data to the edge profile of this panel, and I'm merely tracing this panel out onto a piece of paper. Yes, I probably could have stuck it directly onto the scanner, but that can sometimes be difficult with lighting situations. So a little bit better to trace it out. And it's also going to allow me to make some adjustments, because ultimately I'm reproducing this data because the tooling is no longer any good for this panel. It's starting to break down and it needs to be recut. So this is a perfect time to check out the accuracy of photogrammetry and see what we can come up with. This is the edge trace of that panel, and this is what we're going to use to compare to the scan. We pull in the images into Metashape and we get a pretty nice scan. You'll see most of the images come out from the one side. The other side does not. I suspect this has something to do with the fact that the panel is so flat on the other side. It has a tough time registering those images, I think. At any rate, it does give me a scan. It is a little bit rougher textured on the side where the photos don't come in, but the scan does build, and I'm pretty happy with that. So Metashape makes an OBJ file, and I'm going to pull this into my CAD software. So I'm going to pull this into Fusion 360. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to try to line up or square up the data, because when it creates the data, it has no reference to square, up, down, right, left, or anything in the world. And so we need to do that first to make this data usable. And I'm just trying to square things up, and I'm mainly eyeballing it because I can make further slight tweaks and adjustments as we need when we're moving forward. So the next thing I do is I create a line that is the length or the width of the panel, and I'm going to use this line as my reference to scale up the line drawing or the edge profile of the scan. And this is how I get the scan to the correct size. And so I do some fine adjustment here, making the scan straight and square to that line, that reference line that I created. And then what we'll do after that is we'll scale up the scan that we got out of Metashape, that OBJ file, and we'll get that to the right size and tweak that in square. So sorry, I don't have any capture of that. What I'm doing now is taking a slice or a section out of this scan data. It's just too big and too cumbersome, and all I need is a section out of the middle to compare to the end for our sample so that we can recreate the data. And I'll show you here really quick on the panel what I've done, basically by laying down a piece of tape of what we're going to get this cross section. And you'll see I can actually press on the panel and it goes up and down a little. There's a little flex, there's a little variance in the middle of the panel, and you can see that right here.
Hey, thanks for checking out my video about photogrammetry. I hope you like it. If you haven't already done so, feel free to subscribe to my channel, give the video a thumbs up if you like it, and hit the bell so you get the little parentheses around the notifications bell, and you'll be notified every time I have a new video, which is usually about once a week. If you're a current subscriber and you feel you're not getting notifications because I think there's a little bug in the system, even though YouTube says it's been fixed and many of my friends say they're not being notified of my new videos, you may need to unsubscribe, resubscribe, and then hit that bell again so you get those parentheses to be notified about my new videos. Thanks again for watching. I want to thank all of my subscribers. I definitely couldn't do this channel without you. Thanks for your support.
All right. Now that we got things lined up on top of each other, we can see there is a slight variance in between the outline that we created and the scan. But by slight, I'm talking less than a millimeter in difference, which is probably pretty darn close, considering that the panel flexes just a tiny bit in the middle. And so I suspect that things are pretty close with the photogrammetry here. And so this new line that I'm creating for the new tooling to be cut, I'm kind of splitting the difference and making adjustments, making things flat on the bottom where I know they need to be. And then I'm making adjustments on some of the other curves so that they look nice and you'll get some nice highlights tracking through the panel. And so I spend a fair amount of time trying to recapture sort of the flavor of the original panel. I assume this panel is, you know, 30 years old or something like that. This is old Kirksite tooling. It's probably done in the late 90s or something like that, is my guess. And the tooling has roughness in it, and the panels aren't being stamped flat anymore. And of course, you can see that when you paint the paint panel and you're getting not good reflections or uneven highlights in the panel. And so that's, of course, not acceptable for a paint panel where you want to see the colors. Once the line is done, it's just a matter of extruding that profile, and here you can see it overlaid, weaving sort of in and out a little bit of the original scan, and pretty darn close. So my conclusion about photogrammetry is that it's pretty darn accurate, well within tolerances of what I need, and probably well within tolerances of what anybody needs, I would think, if you are trying to recreate some data or reverse engineer something to make a new product with. I'm super happy with the accuracy of the Metashape, so pretty good stuff. Hey, and don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook sometimes, Twitter usually, and now Instagram. Rock on. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.